Do the meaning of words really matter? Does it matter if a word is singular or plural? When it comes to the words of the Bible, every word matters. I'm going to show you something, a special word in Hebrew. You'd never see it in English, but it can change your life. In the Book of Mysteries, there's a mystery called Rachamim. Now, we all seek mercy. We want the mercy of God. Sometimes we think, have I used it up? Lord, do you have mercy? Please have mercy on me. Does he still love me? You know, and the Bible is about mercy. I mean, it's about the sacrifice. It's about mercy. The Lord has mercy. And it says that Messiah, he died for our sins. Why? Because of mercy. It's all about the mercy of God, the forgiveness, the grace of God. But in the Book of Mysteries, the teacher asks a question to the disciple, and he says, does God have mercy on you? And the disciple says, yes, of course. I'm going to tell you something that's going to shock you, and you're probably going to get real upset, but hang on. And the answer is, God does not have mercy for you. God does not have mercy on you. Why? Well, you'd say, in the Bible, it says, to the Lord our God belongs mercy and forgiveness. But in the original language, it doesn't say to the Lord belongs mercy. It says to the Lord belongs rachamim. What is rachamim? Some Bibles, most Bibles, would translate it as mercy. So you read, the Lord has mercy. But that's not what it says. It says the Lord has rachamim. Well, rachamim doesn't mean mercy. Rachamim literally means mercies. It's plural. And in fact, you cannot say in Hebrew, you can't say mercy as a noun singular. You can only talk about God's mercy plural. What does that mean? In Hebrew, it's an amazing thing. You can't say it in English. It means that God's mercy is so great, so strong, and so deep that you cannot contain it in a single word. Whatever you think of God's mercy, it's more than that. Whatever you imagine his mercy, you cannot even, it's bigger, it's better, it's more. It means when it says rachamim, it's a way of saying that this is so big, you cannot even imagine his mercy. It means that it's so big, there's no end to his mercy. There's no end, it's plural. Now, what about the word for sin? What about that? Is the word for sin, your sins, my sins, is it singular or plural? Well, the word for your sin, my sin, is singular, but the word for God's mercy is plural. What does that mean? It means that no matter how many sins you have, no matter how great, no matter how big your sins, the mercy of God is always greater. No matter how much sin you have, there's more mercy to cover it, no matter what it is. It means that God always has more mercy than you have sin. So don't ever make the mistake of thinking that you've exhausted the mercy of God, or you've exhausted the love of God, or you've exhausted the patience of God. You can't, because whatever you do is finite. But what he does for you, it is forever. It's infinite. It's infinite. That's why it says his mercies are forever, are everlasting. No matter how much you sin, no matter how much you've sinned, no matter how much you're sinning now, I mean, you want to get away from it, but no matter how much you will sin, know that you put all those sins together, it still will not even equal a fraction of the mercy of God. God has far more mercy than you have sin. You will never exhaust it. There will always be compassion, not only for your sins, but there'll be extra left over to cover everything from now to eternity. So open your heart today to discover not just the mercy of God, but the rachamim of God, the overflowing rivers of his compassion and love, which never end, ever, 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 because you only have sin. But God has rachamim for you, and that's not mercy, it's mercies forever and ever and ever. There's a wedding in the Bible that has everything to do with your life.